The U.S. Air Force has reached a significant milestone in developing its new stand-in attack weapon, or SiAW, successfully completing the missile's first test release from an F-16 Fighting Falcon. Although the test was conducted on November 7th over the Gulf of Mexico, the achievement was officially announced on December 2nd. This successful trial marks a key step toward advancing the evaluation of the Tactical Air-to-Surface Missile System, which aims to strengthen the U.S. military's strike capabilities. The test employed a Jettison Test Vehicle, JTV, a non-functional prototype without a rocket motor or electronics, to validate the safe separation of the SiAW missile from the aircraft. This critical step ensures the missile can be safely deployed in operational scenarios and sets the stage for future testing phases. The mission was coordinated by the 96th Test Wing, with operation managed from the Eglin Central Control Facility. Engineers and pilots collaborated closely to ensure the test's success, while aerial footage was captured to aid in post-flight analysis. Major James Tipton, Assistant Director of Operations for the 780th Test Squadron, commended the effort, describing it as a testament to the outstanding teamwork from everyone involved. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Stand-in Attack Weapon, SiAW, is imperative for the U.S. military. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. In May 2022, Northrop, along with Lockheed Martin and L3 Harris, were awarded a $2 million contract by the Air Force to initiate the first phase of SiAW development. Northrop beat out L3 Harris for the development contract. Lockheed Martin withdrew from the competition. The Air Force's objective for this weapon is to effectively engage and neutralize ground-based enemy air defense targets that have the potential for rapid mobility. These targets encompass integrated air defense systems, ballistic missile launchers, land attack and anti-ship cruise missile launchers, GPS jammers, as well as anti-satellite systems. Near-peer rivals like Russia and China have deployed long-range air defense to create virtual anti-access area denial bubble. This is aimed at denying a much more powerful U.S. Air Force from gaining air superiority in case of a conflict. The U.S. Air Force is very much cognizant of this fact. In recent years, the military branch has actively pursued the modernization of its aircraft and weapons systems to effectively operate in a challenging and hostile environment against technologically advanced adversaries. This shift represents a departure from the two decades of warfare primarily conducted in uncontested airspace within the Middle East. The development of a missile designed to target enemy air defenses is a clear indication of this strategic reorientation. SiAW is an air-to-ground weapon designed to deliver striking power for effectively neutralizing swiftly moving targets within an adversary's anti-access area denial environment. In response to evolving threats, the missile's design incorporates open architecture interfaces, enabling swift upgrades to its subsystems and the deployment of enhanced capabilities for quick response to newer threats. The SiAW builds on the HARM, or High-Speed Anti-Radiation Missile, and the AARGM-ER, advanced anti-radiation guided missile extended range. But while they may appear identical externally, SiAW is an all-new weapon. Anti-radiation missile, like AARGM-ER, is designed as a counter to advanced air defense systems. This kind of missile is designed to detect and home in on enemy radio emission source. Typically, these are designed for use against an enemy radar, although jammers and even radios used for communications can also be targeted in this manner. Compared to AARGM-ER, SiAW will be used against a broader range of anti-access area denial targets beyond air defense radars, such as command and control sites, ballistic missile and cruise missile launchers, GPS jamming systems, anti-satellite systems, and other high-value or fleeting targets. Its actual range and speed have not been divulged, but the AARGM-ER is believed to be a Mach 4 missile with a range of 180 miles, or about 290 kilometers, and the SiAW may have better performance. Despite its enhanced operational envelope, SiAW is designed as a stand-in weapon, signifying its readiness to engage within an adversary's defended airspace. As per Northrop, SiAW has tail control vanes and other means of being stealthy, and has multiple sensors and an inertial navigation system that can take over if global positioning system satellite location signals are jammed. It can also communicate with other platforms and weapons and attack target coordinates supplied by another platform. The SiAW program places significant emphasis on digital engineering and design, marking the first instance where the U.S. Air Force has embarked on a comprehensive weapons acquisition and development program that is entirely digitally driven. As per NATO's war doctrine, air superiority is the number one priority, and advanced air defense systems are a major hurdle. Russia has deployed S-300 and S-400, and is in the process of operationalizing the S-500. China has HQ-9 and HQ-12 SAM. While the war in Ukraine has shown that these systems are not invincible, they are a pressing threat to aerial assets like fighters, bombers, aerial tankers, and airborne warning and control system aircraft. This is where SiAW comes in. As per details presented by the U.S. Air Force FY24 budget documents, the SiAW Rapid Prototyping Initiative is allocated a total budget of $1.14 billion. Apart from F-16, it's supposed to equip F-35 and B-21 Raider bomber. To maintain these stealth characteristics, SiAW would be housed within the aircraft's internal bay rather than being mounted externally. F-35 would be able to carry two SiAWs internally. These stealthy platforms carrying SiAW would be the perfect counter to advanced air defenses developed by rivals. The U.S. Air Force wants this weapon to reach its initial operational capability by 2026.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.